But salvation is offered to all men. Say all men.
All men.
So it's when he died on the cross, all our sins are canceled, past, future, and present. All men. All men. His intention is to save. Why? Does it mean that all men save? No. Only the one that received him as Lord and Savior are saved. Amen?
Amen.
And then it is wrong to say that I didn't get the Holy Spirit yet, sister. I'm saved. Yeah, I'm born again now. I didn't get the Holy Spirit yet. That is not true. Once you're saved, you have the Holy Spirit. You have the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
But the difference is the baptism of the Holy Ghost is different from being saved. Amen? When you have baptized with the Holy Ghost, you have supernatural. It's supernatural. You perform supernatural things. Amen. You are supernatural. You have a power. When you baptize with the Holy Ghost, you have the power. Yes, you have the Holy Spirit when you're saved. But you don't stop there. You need to have baptism of the Holy Spirit to get the power. Amen? Amen. So every good gift and every perfect gift is from above.
Yes.
Coming down from the Father of life. The Father of life is, when I look at the Amplified Bible, the Father of Life means creator and sustainer of the heavens. Creator and sustainer of heaven. So coming down from the Father of Life, with whom is no variableness. Can you think of any word that says variableness? What does it mean when you say variableness? There is no. What is the other word of variableness? There's no difference. There's no, it's the same. No variableness, neither shadow of turning. So everything, that perfect gift that God gave us, is not going to change. God is not an Indian giver. Everyone say that. God is not an Indian giver.
God is not an Indian giver.
No, once he gave you, that's it. He's not the one that would say, Give that back to me. I remember there's a story, right? There's a story about brother and sister. Hello, saints. There's a story between brother and sister. They have a land. The sister has a land. The land.
It's a precious
gift. The sister has a land. So the brother wants to buy that land because the land have a plenty to harvest. Like different kinds of plenty to harvest, so many vegetables, so many things to harvest, and you will profit a lot of money, right? So the sister one day was in financial needs. So the sister said, I want to sell you my land. So he gave the land to the brother, and the brother bought the land. But here comes the flood. The flood and the storm came, right? Now the land, what happened to the land? The land was flooded, all right? So the land flooded. So who owned the land now? Because who bought the land? The brother bought it. Hold on a minute, I'm being confused here. The sister had a land. The sister was now, what do you call this? The sister, The sister is in financial needs, so he gave the land to the brother. First of all, the brother had the land, and now it's making a lot of money because he has harvested. He harvested a lot. He profited a lot of money. So the sister now, Sister Dean, the sister said, why did I give my land to my brother? I have to take it back. He's earning a lot of money. How come I gave my land to my brother? No. So she has not talked to her brother for a long period of time. She don't want to talk to her brother. So she's mad. She don't want that happen. Then why did she give the land to her brother? Here comes the brother and says, why are you mad at me? Did I do something to you? Did I do something? Did I make you cry or something? You know what the sister said? The sister said, give me back my land. someone give you a present. I know I gave you Clever one day. Mm-hmm. I gave my dog Clever one day to my dad. And then I have another dog, which is more expensive than Clever. But I love Clever than this dog, than the expensive dog. So I said, Dad, I want Clever back. So that this man is profiting, she's mad because why did she sold the property? So I said, I want my land back. The brother said, why? Why are you doing this? I already bought it from you. The title is mine. No, but I want my land back. So just because he loves his sister, he gave back the land. He gave it back. So here it is. Here's the title. You can have it. You pay me back next time when you have money. You can have the land. So she gets the land. After like 2 weeks, here comes the flood, the storm. And the whole area was flooded.
Wow!
Because she's an Indian giver. She gave it, but when she saw that it was prospering, she wanted that. Because this is our natural feeling as human beings. When we know that our sister or brother are prospering, we get jealous. And we want those things back. Why did I bless the person? She's more blessed than me now. I want that back. See? That's a natural feeling. But then, you see, that's an example of an Indian giver. But God gave us life. Amen? And have it more abundantly. When God anoints us, he's not going to take that back. Amen?
Amen.
Everyone say, I'm anointed.
I'm anointed.
Everyone say, I'm anointed.
I'm anointed.
Do you know that Lucifer was anointed too? Lucifer, we say that, was anointed.
Yeah.
His body is made of instrument. He is anointed cherub. He's an anointed angel. God did not take that away from him. That's why the music rap now in the world, it sounds like it's anointed and everything, but it's not anointed. But there is a perversion in that anointing. Amen?
Yeah.
Lucifer was anointed. That's why there's a music ministry. Always Satan always attack the music ministry. Because that is the specialty of Lucifer. Lucifer loves music. He's an anointed angel. God did not take that away. He put him down. He fell down. But he did not took the anointing away from Lucifer. Lucifer was still anointed. Because God gave. Anything God gave, he's not going to take it back. He's not an Indian giver. He gave you life. He's not going to take back your life. Amen?
Amen.
In Job 1, you can just read it at your house. In Job 1, verse 21, Job said, God gave it and he can take away blessings. He gave it and he can take away blessings.
Amen.
And blessed be the name of the Lord. But just remember, in Job, Satan went to get permission from God to attack Job, to get his wealth, to give him some sickness. He asked permission from God.
Yeah.
So in other words, these things didn't come from God. And Job said in Job 1 verse 21, that the Lord gave it and took it back. But then in Job 42, he rejected what he said. Job 42, Sister Dean, verse 3 to 6, let's look at it to make sure that what he said is right. Job 42, verse 3 to 6. 42, first of all, Job 1, verse 21, he said the Lord gave it and he's going to take it back. And then in Job 42, he repented. He repented. Job 42, verse 3 to 6. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Look at Job 42, verse 3 to 6. Amen. If you're there, amen.
Job 42.
Verse
42.
42.
Verses 3 through 6.
Yes, verse 3 to 6.
Who is he that hideth counsel without knowledge? Therefore have I uttered that I understood not things too wonderful for me which I knew not. Hear, I beseech thee, and I will speak. I will demand of thee, and declare thou unto me. I have heard of thee by the hearing of the ear, but now mine eye seeth not. Wherefore I abhor myself, and repent in dust and ashes.
Amen. He repented the words that he said to the Lord. He would say, that's not you, Lord. You don't give it and take it away. That is not the Lord that I know. That's why he repented. I uttered that I understood not. I did not understand you. Amen? He realized that what he said is wrong. Because our God is not a medium giver. Amen?
Amen.
So what happened when he repented? After he repented, what happened? God restored everything from him to the being.
Yes.
He gave back his wealth. He gave back, he's more richer than ever.
Yes.
He had more life to him. He multiplied his life. Amen?
Yes.
And when he died, it was full age. Full age.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Because he repented what he said. Then he said that the Lord took it away. And the Lord give you something and took it away. That's not the God of that's not our God. Our God is not a God of punisher. Our God came to die on the cross of the Calvary so that we will be blessed and have it more abundantly, have life. Amen.
Amen.
Our God came to deliver us from all unrighteousness, to deliver them from all Satan's works and works of the devil, to forgive our sins. To give us good life, to give you prosperity, to deliver us from the works of the enemy, amen? To give us life. That's why God came. He's not the God of punisher. Amen? He's not the God of punisher. Okay? Because it is better now. That's why he came and he died in the cross of the Calvary. Amen. So besides the gift of the Holy Spirit. What other gift that we have? The gift of life, every day when we breathe, that is a gift. Every time we have our life is a gift. When we have a job, that's a gift. And you read a while ago, Deacon Smith read a while ago, what is the gift that we read? There's something that you read? That is a gift of God. Oh, labor! When you have the fruits of your labor and you want to enjoy it, that is the gift of God.
Yes.
There's nothing wrong with enjoying the fruits of your labor.
Yes.
It is the gift of God. Amen?
Yes.
It is the gift of God. The gift of righteousness. Amen? Those are the gifts. So when your husband and wife is a gift too. Do you believe that? That your husband and wife is a gift too. So be gentle. Be nice. Be nice because they are the gift too. Don't say that I'm giving it back to your mother or your father. You might as well. He is a gift too. Okay?
And also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God.
It is the gift of God. Amen. And John 6, verse 32. Read that for me.
John 6, verse 32 says,
Thank you, Lord.
And Jesus said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not that bread from heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven.
Okay, so what I'm saying to you is, the salvation is a gift of God. Amen?
Amen.
It's a gift of God. Okay? Because during the Ten Commandments, it's very hard to get salvation. Because you have to do all these commandments in order for you to be approved by God. In order to be righteous, you have to follow all the commandments. If you don't follow the commandments, you are not blessed. If you don't follow the commandments, God will curse you. Amen? That if you don't do this, do that, do this, it's demanding. Deuteronomy 28 is about demanding. Demanding what God wants you to do. Demanding and demanding and demanding. But then the new covenant, Jesus Christ came. He made a way in order for us to to prepare us to heaven, to get the eternal life. It's very easy now. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. And Deacon Smith read John 6:32, and I'm going to say it again, that Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not the bread from heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. So Jesus Christ is full of truth and, what does it say?
Life.
And full of truth. The chapter that I read last time, Jesus Christ is full of truth. So Jesus Christ is the only way. Moses is not the real way to go to salvation. He already said that. So the only one that can follow the Ten Commandments or the other commandments is Jesus. No man can follow the commandments. If you say that I did all the commandments, you're lying. The rich man ruler lied. The rich man ruler lied to Jesus. When he asked, what shall I do in order to enter into the kingdom of God? Then Jesus said, obey all the commandments. The rich man ruler saying, what? I did all the commandments, amen. All, everything. So what else I have to do? Sell all your possessions, give it to the poor. And he feels sad. He don't want to give anything to the Lord. Then he says, when it comes to money, don't touch my money. no one wants to give to the Lord. Amen? But then I said, the way, the Ten Commandments, but then it now different. On the book of Acts, when somebody asked to Paul and Silas, what must I do in order to be saved? What Paul said? Paul said, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. It's easier now. Amen?
Amen.
The salvation now is easier. The new covenant. Jesus made a way for salvation to be smooth. Like Deacon Spence read John 6:32 says that, verily I say to you, Moses gave you not the bread of heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. Amen? So it's full of truth and grace is Jesus Christ. He made a way smoothly. I will tell you how he made a way smoothly about salvation. Let's look at Rome. Hallelujah. Let's look at Luke 3.